Good morning, everybody, and welcome back to the channel. So it is Labor Day weekend, and we are at the annual steam show at Heston Steam Park. So we decided that we'd bring you along. So it is Labor Day weekend 2024. We try to come here at least once a year, and this is when we got a chance to come. So let's go ride some trains, go see some cool stuff. Looks like they had some Alice Chalmers tractors on display. So let's go see what they got. So something really cool this year at Heston is their new blacksmith shop. We'll check that out in a little bit. But we're gonna come look at the two-cylinder Club of Michiana's display. This is really neat. A John Deere MT dualed up. ...1955 John Deere 60, 59630. I need to find me a 630 to go with the 620. 530. John Deere 70. 37A with fenders. So we'll look at some tractors and then we'll get on to some trains and some other steam stuff. Let's see what we got over here. 1950 Alice Chalmers CA. Didn't know there was a CA. Ford. 48 Farmall H. A couple more H's. Co-op E3 1947, 153 cubic inch, 4-cylinder engine. John Deere B. John Deere 70 diesel, 1956. John Deere 110, like mine. 51 John Deere G. Ooh, looky here. 55 John Deere 70 all fuel. That's a pretty tractor. Firestone tires. Just the way Dad likes them. Now we've seen this tractor several times. It floats around in this area, but it's always a pleasure to see it. Detroit powered. Looks like we got some hit and miss engines over here. Let's go check those out. The new blacksmith shop. This is a beautiful building. Thank you. So I really like the wiring in this building because it's the old bear style wire like they used in the old days with the porcelain insulators. It's a really cool touch. So these are the Alice's that caught my eye when we pulled in. We got a D21 here on the end.
I've watched it a few times now, just trying to figure out what they're.
A small 50-15 garden tractor. 60-80. This one's really neat. Front wheel assist. A 60-60. Never seen one of these before. And another 60-60 two-wheel drive. Look to be fully restored. Got a Oliver 88 diesel. Another Super 88. Well, that's a row crop. This is a Super 88. A 66 row crop. An 880. I don't think I've ever seen an 880. Diesel. Huh. And a 60. My buddy Jacob's got a 60. And it's the smoothest tractor I've ever been around running. It just runs like a sewing machine. So this is a new attraction. That is a big steam tractor, 120 horse. The actual steam engine is underneath the boiler. Down here instead of being up top like the cases. Definitely is a big tractor. Looks like a locomotive on wheels basically. Let's go behind it. Thank you. We're gonna start sawing some wood. Thank you. that's a Baker fan he's running right now. It's like a dyno for steam tractors. One year down to Power from the Past, my dad has John Deere 60 on one, and he actually broke their belt. Kind of upset him a little bit. That was the 60 that he used to pull. Also use them for breaking them in also, and diagnostic purposes. Beautiful 57 720. 57, that'd be the same year as his dad's. We gotta get dad's painted. Oh, it's an electric start though. Took the nostalgia out of it. signal's 12 o'clock. Well, it's now getting close to 12:30, and they're going to start the thrashing machine. I'm going to do some thrashing here. Got some wheat already thrashed. Looks nice and clean. So this is a Avery thrashing machine. It's really neat because that bucket up there, you can set what weight you want, and when it trips, that's how much weight just dumped out of there. I don't know what they've got it set for. So that's how they can kind of keep track of how many pounds or bushels or whatever they've run through the thrashing machine. So this was the predecessor to the self-propelled combine. Thank you. this is a John Deere hay press, and they're baling straw with it. And it's wire tied. So they put the straw in, and it bales it. And then Jay's down there tying wires to tie the bales together. The board goes in between so you can put the wire through. Alright, I gotta go catch the train. Madison's holding us a spot in line. Economy hitting this engine. So that's how they baled hay and straw back in the day.
Thank you. as we work our way down from Glacier Pass, we're going to do a series of S-curves here, and you'll be able to get a good look at the workings of the Shea locomotive. Unlike a conventional steam locomotive, which has pistons and drive rods on both sides for the wheels, our whole drive system is on the right side of the locomotive, and we have three vertical pistons that operate a drive shaft that run the entire length of the locomotive and the tender. This locomotive is literally all-wheel drive. These were industrial and forestry locomotives, mining locomotives. They are not fast, but they have a lot of traction power. The top speed of a Shea is only about 17 miles an hour. The Henson engine is also unique in that we were never railroad. This was laid out as a museum. And we are also narrow gauge. We are dual narrow gauge. We are 3 foot what we're riding on today, and we can also operate 2 foot European. Gets its day. But Peter and Alice Hess, who moved here in the 1850s from what is now Germany, and opened a dry goods and general store in the area where the Hessian Supper Club is now. In 1865, they got permission to put a post office in there. On the U.S. Postal Service are the name for the area. So then Hess is named them after themselves. His name Hess. Hessians are buried in the Methodist Cemetery here in Hess. Thank you. Virginia and Michigan line just off the left side of the train. And we are going to do our steepest climb up Michigan curve here. We're going to be climbing better than 50%. Right, you'll see some of the bridges put on little trains, including Elaine Bridge here, where you go under and over on your journey with them. Purchase of the flea market up on the hill and other vendors. lots of stay and do. Have a safe journey home. Please remain seated till the engineers and then you leave the combine.
Well, as always, it's been a wonderful time here at Heston Steam Park. We had a great time, enjoyed all the sights and sounds of the past, and now we're going to go find something to eat because we're hungry, right? We're going to the Olive Garden, I guess. So thank you for watching. Greatly appreciate it. We'll see you all in the next one. Hopefully Jay don't get too wild on his Ford tractor here. But I'd like to thank all these guys for putting on such a wonderful show. And there he goes. All right. We'll see you all in the next one. Thank you for watching.